So, welcome back to a slightly different surroundings. I'm working at home now, and yes, it's I think interesting times is the understatement of the century. So things for me have cancelled, workshops have cancelled, weddings are kind of in the balance, and I know for a lot of people in my industry, at least, this is a massively stressful time. Difficult to know what's happening. It's very uncertain. And so, how do you go forward? And so, one has to reshape one's day. And was thinking about the sort of tutorial side of things of doing YouTube stuff, and thinking actually, I really enjoy it. I love doing it. So I'm going to carry on. I'm going to carry on. I've got a lot more stuff growing in the garden, which is lovely. I think my garden will be Chelsea Flower Show by the summer. But I wanted to carry on sharing stuff with you. Ideas that I've found, things that I've been thinking about. And one thing I posted back at the weekend was a picture of a corsage on my Instagram page. And it was just a really simple idea that a florist who worked for me a long time ago showed me, and it was just a really simple idea. I'm not being weird. I'm just pulling eucalyptus leaves off of this branch. So this is just large leaf eucalyptus, and I want ones different sizes, some large, some small. They're not coming off particularly. There you go. So just pulling them off, literally, com C, com Sa. So that's your starter for 10. And essentially, you're going to make little funnels. So you've got the leaf like that, and you're just going to roll it round. Get yourself around your finger. Get yourself a fine rose wire. Make a hairpin. Lay it on. Catch the end of the leaf, and then you've got yourself a little tube. So let me show you another one. So you're based from the point where the leaf connects to the stem of the eucalyptus, so down the centre, just folding it over in your, well, sort of twirling it over in your fingers. The only thing I can liken it to So you're
is
basically
when
making the funnel.
I
Used to make as a kid, and you would make a funnel out of sort of baking paper to do some piping with. It's a childhood memory for me. Oh, see, okay, so that one wasn't, that came apart. Let's try again. You need to catch enough of the eucalyptus to make it stay in place. So, hairpin. There you go, that's better. So, it's kind of catching the bottom here, enough of the bottom with the wire. To make sure that it's secure. So that's two. Let's do one more. So hairpin. Catch it with a wire. And there you go. So you could tape these. So just got to tape cakes with my mum. Okay, so got one, two, and there's a third down here. Okay, so we've got the three funnels. I've also got some rosemary, just because it's a lovely foliage to use in the from the garden. So going to do a hairpin wire for that one. And I think having a nice selection of herbs in the garden is always useful. So I've got rosemary, sage, mint, and oregano, I think. I've also got some lavender, which the snails, for some reason, are attacking. Right, just tape these. Okay, so flower-wise, I have some Coco Casino Hypericum. So this is just a real sort of baby pink Hypericum. Nice as a texture. And I've also got some Lysianthus. So this is Rosita Red. So it's basically like a dark, sort of dark cerise pink, essentially. So I'm going to do two bigger buds and then two smaller heads. I think that'll be good. So with these, I'm just going to silver wire, just put it into the head. And whether you can see that. So just into the base of the flower head, and then twist the wire around. So I'll show you again. And it's kind of interesting how corsages, I mean, if you look at them, how they've changed style-wise, I think. I mean, I still tape everything up. I really struggle psychologically to not tape stuff, I think, when it comes to buttonholes and corsages. I don't know why. But I know that people don't, and they kind of do the gathered look with a very beautiful piece of ribbon. But, yeah, this is just how I do them. So, big head. Chisel the wire around. So I'll tape, actually, I'll do the Hypericum first. Hypericum. I think probably, so I've got a bit cut like that. I think I'll probably just do a hairpin. So twist the wire around. And it's always good, I think, when you're doing, it's surprising how long corsages can take. So if you're doing a wedding, I don't know, with 5, 6, 7, 8, you know, up to 10 corsages, it's great to have all of the bits just ready to go. So tape everything and wire everything that you need. And then you can just construct quite quickly. So I'm just going to take the Lysianthus. So while I'm doing this, I fully appreciate that a lot of people probably now are working from home, and that it's a massive shift and very sudden shift for people. And it feels like a really bewildering sort of time. And I know I was talking to my brother last night, that that feeling of reading the news and just getting that overwhelming sense of panic. But actually, I've taken the choice to take Facebook off my phone, take Twitter off my phone, and also take the BBC News website off my phone. And it's not that I want to stick my head in the sand, but I know that for me, to survive and to care for my family, it's important that, you know, I do this to enable myself to cope with what's happening, to cope with the shift that's happening in my business, you know, and look at ways for me to move forward. So yeah, that's my 2 pence worth. But also, you know, realizing how valuable your community around you that you have is. You know, you still need people to cheer you on. You still need to be able to reach out to people and say, I'm really struggling with this, or, you know, whatever. And I think also I'm thankful, you know, for my church community that we have around us. Well, they are jolly good. Right, I've just taped 2 pieces of maidenhair, no, not maidenhair fern, asparagus fern, sorry, my brain went blank. Asparagus fern, just as a kind of backing. So I'll just tape those. So yeah, if anything, I think it's really important to keep reaching out to people, keep talking, keep phoning people up. And also, you know, take time off of social media, go read a book, work in the garden, walk the dog. Okay. So I have all my bits ready to go. So I've got lisianthus, I've got eucalyptus tubes, nice, hypericum, and also got rosemary and the fern. So I'm going to start with the fern. Old school corsage, I think, would be of you'd think about it in a diamond shape. I tend to think about it as a kind of triangle, but just with a dipped bottom, sort of a, yeah. So you're wanting to create a point at the top, and that's where, you know, the fern is quite nice. And then start building from there. The nice thing about holding it just sort of in your left hand is you can move stuff around if you need to. And because everything's wide and taped, it makes it easier. So I'll add one of these funnels in. Okay, so that was kind of an interesting process. It all felt a bit angular, but I've done it in a kind of grouped sort of fashion. So you can kind of see it's got two heads together here of the Lizzie, two of the cream buds, two of the hypericum little berries, some rosemary, there's ferns at the back, and two of these eucalyptus tubes here. I did put a piece of eucalyptus at the back as well, just to kind of even it out, to balance. So it's a bit kind of angular, but I kind of like it, it's kind of fun. So I'll do a close-up of that and you can see it. But these, I just really wanted to show these tubes, just because it's another way of adding texture, just another little design technique that you could use. And you could wire and tape lots of those, and you could even put them into headdresses, they'd be quite effective. So I hope that's helpful. And yes, I look forward to seeing you again next time.